الله أكبر الله أكبر
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أربع حق على الله ألا يدخلهم الجنة ولا يذيقهم نعيمها. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in this hadith that أربع, four people, كان حق على الله ألا يدخلهم الجنة. It is the right, and the right here meaning obligation upon Allah not to make them enter the Jannah and enter or grant them the Jannah. وَلَا يَذُوقُ نَعِيمَهَا, and they will not even feel the joy of the Jannah. Meaning they will be so far from the Jannah. They will be in a very, very far distance from the Jannah. أربع, four people. حق على الله ألا يدخلهم الجنة. It is حق upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to grant them the entrance of the Jannah. ولا يذيقهم نعيمها, and not to make them feel the joy of it. Even they cannot see it from, for example, a distance. They cannot feel it. They cannot see people in it are enjoying. مدمن الخمر. مدمن الخمر. That's the first one. وآكل الربا. That's the second one. وآكل مال اليتيم بغير حق. That's the third one. والعاق لوالديه. That's the fourth one. Bring them again. مدمن الخمر, the one who always drink alcohol, alcoholic person. مدمن comes from addictive, so he's addicting the khamr. It's not somebody who maybe had once and he made tawbah, or sometime and then he made tawbah. That's different. This hadith talking about the person that has the habit of drinking the khamr his life, and then he die in that state. Be clear. The person who die drinking or having the habit of drinking khamr, he will not enter the Jannah. Allah will not grant him the Jannah or even the feeling of the joy for Jannah. وَآكِلْ الْرِبَى, the one who eat the riba. Eat the riba. The riba is the interest. The interest. وَآكِلْ الْرِبَى, the one who eat the interest. وَآكِلْ مَالِ الْيَتِيمِ بِغَيْرِ حَقٍ, and the one who eat the money of the yatim, the orphan, without justification. Somebody taking a donation for the yatim and he's eating them. Or somebody who's looking after the yatim and eating the money of yatim. An uncle of yatim maybe, and he got the wealth for yatim and he's eating it for himself. بغير حق, meaning that sometimes people eat from the mal of the yatim with حق, with justification. If this person is looking after the yatim, he is poor himself and he's caring of the yatim, he's a carer and he is poor, unemployed, but because he's caring for the yatim, he is eating with the yatim. So he do shopping, he bring the food. When the yatim eats, he eats with him, because himself doesn't have anything as well. That is the haqq. But akil mal al yatim bi ghayri haqq, somebody who has, he's rich, he's not poor, but he's greedy and he's taking the mal of yatim. Wal aaq li waliday, the one who displeases his parents, the one who displeases his parents, al aaq li waliday, doesn't talk to them, doesn't care about them, doesn't please them, he doesn't care whether they are happy or not from him. He's not considering his parents' well-being and the happiness and pleasure from his side. This hadith, I think, is very scary, isn't it? But we can see these are common in the Muslim Ummah. People eating without justification, people eating riba, people having alcohol. Even in Muslim countries, some governments, they give license for alcohol for some places. Hotels in some Muslim countries, they have alcohol. Some now even shops, they have license to sell alcohol in Muslim countries. So it's very scary, of course, very scary, promoting these things. Next hadith. Now I am taking you to my main topic, but bear with me and focus. This hadith in Sahih Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna Allah tayyibun la yaqbalu illa tayyiban." Allah is tayyib, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't accept the tayyib, the good, meaning the halal sources. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ أَمَرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ بِمَا أَمَرَ بِهِ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the believers as exactly he commanded the mursaleen, the messengers. فَقَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, this is not my words, this is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is khutbah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the hadith. فَقَالَ تَعَالَى يَا أَيُّهَا الرُّسُلُ كُنُوا مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَاعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا. And Allah said in the Quran, this is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, Allah said in the Quran, oh the messengers of Allah, ya ayyuha rusul, kulu min at-tayyibat, eat from the good. Don't eat from the khabith. Eat from the good, from the halal. Wa'malu saliha, and do good. And Allah commanded the believers exactly by the same way that he commanded the mursaleen. That's the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he said, وَقَالَ تَعَالَى يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُلُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. The Prophet ﷺ saying, look at what Allah said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, O believers, كُلُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Eat from the طَيِّبَات. Eat from the طَيِّبَات of what we provided for you. So same ayah, يَا أَيُّهَا الرُّسُلْ, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. But the context and the meaning, the order, the command is the same for the rusul and for the believers in terms of your food, your eating, your earning. ثُمَّ ذَكَرَ, meaning the Prophet ﷺ, he mentioned after that, الرَّجُلْ, a man, a man. This applies to both, of course, man and woman. A man, يطيل السفر, he's traveling, أشعث أغبر. You look at him because he's traveling, he has dust, his clothes not ironed, and they are not new or clean. أغبر, you can look at his face, the tiredness and the travel feature there. يمد يديه إلى السماء, and he raised his hands. Ya Rab, Ya Rab, You know the traveler, his dua is accepted. We know that. وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامٌ His food from haram. وَمَشْرَبُهُ حَرَامٌ And his water, his drink from haram. وَمَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامٌ And his clothes from haram. وَغُذِّيَ بِالْحَرَامِ And he is fed with haram. فَأَنَّ يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ How Allah will accept his dua? This is the second hadith, remember. The third hadith. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, اجتنبوا السبع الموبقات. Be away. Far distance. اجتنب meaning that you distance yourself. Be free from. Be away from. Abstain from. Seven. Mubiqat. Mubiqat means muhlikat. These things that destroy the person. Mubiqat. That mean muhlikat. And muhlikat in Arabic means the thing that if the person has, he will be destroyed. قالوا وما هن يا رسول الله. They said, what these are? The muhlikat. The mubiqat, those seven. قال الشرك بالله. الشرك بالله. No association anything with Allah. No ibadah. No dhabiha. Qurbani. No any type of ibadah. Except to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Under this we know how many things and what's happening in the Muslim Ummah here and there. And we know many details here. Very scary details about the shirk billah. And we see many practices among the Muslim Ummah. Among the Muslim Ummah, the Ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And how they do their dua and to whom. And how they do their ibadah and to whom. How they do their sadaqah and to whom. He will feel very scared. Somebody putting a piece of metal in his hand, around his hand, and he thinks that this metal will keep him safe and protect him. And if you tell him, what is this? They say, oh, the whole country doing it. And all Mawlanas, they never forbid it. We just feel safe when we put this around our hand. Very scary things you hear among the Muslims. It's not our topic. What's sihr? Number two, the magic. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. If you talk about the magic among the Muslim Ummah. Alhamdulillah. Welcome to the club. وَقَتْلُ النَّفْسِ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهِ وَقَتْلِ النَّفْسِ And killing the nafs, the soul, without justification. The nafs that Allah forbid to kill. Welcome to Syria and Iraq and all over. Muslims killing Muslims. You cannot say that they are not Muslims. They are Muslims. They pray. They pray janaza for their people who are killed. That means they are Muslims. They believe in Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They pray on time. They fight it with each other. Even they have long beards, both sides. And they are killing each other. This week, 100 people. 100 people with long beards. Kill, finish. This is among the Muslim Ummah. وَأَكْلُ الرِّبَى And eating the interest. وَأَكِلْ مَالِ الْيَتِيمَ And eating the orphan's money. وَالتَّوَلِّ يَوْمَ الزَّحْفِ And running away from the jihad. وَقَذْفِ الْمُحْصَنَاتِ الْغَافِلَاتِ الْمُؤْمِنَاتِ Accusing Muslim women. Very innocent Muslim women walking in the street. And just people are sitting around the coffee table or whatever it is. Ah, look at this one. I saw her with so-and-so. I saw her so-and-so. Last night she was so-and-so. He didn't see anything. He didn't see anything but just accusation for the Muslim believers, women. The believing women accusing them with the haram, with the fahisha. If you saw two people, man and woman, naked in one room, you cannot accuse them that they made zina in Islam. Because you didn't see the zina. You saw two naked people. You cannot witness that they made zina because you didn't see the male inside the mikhala. And that's the truth in Islam. If somebody accuses two naked people who are in the same room that they committed zina, he will be punished in the Islamic law. But he spread the fahisha in the society. There's no joke in these things. The person has to see, even if they say, I saw them in one bed. I saw them in the top of each other. Did you see the male inside the mikhala? If he say, I didn't see, then he will be punished. Brothers, remember, these are a'rad al-Muslimin. A'rad al-Muslimin. This hadith in al-Shaykhan, Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. Now, I think these hadith give us great background. Look at the rest of the ayat that I want to list. I'm not going to speak what the ulama say, what the school of thoughts. We have very different school of thoughts. And we are in from very respected school of thoughts. Madhab al-Imam Abu Hanifa, Madhab al-Imam al-Malik, Madhab al-Imam al-Shafi'i, Madhab al-Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. They are all respected. We are all Muslim Ummah. We say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Maybe you have different opinions. But in this issue, look at the ayat and the hadith. And you think and judge. If it is not you, somebody around you, from your family, your relative, your neighbors, your community, your best friends, that's why I'm saying we are affected in a way or another. The first ayah, Allah said, يَمْحَقُ اللَّهُ الرِّبَى وَيُرْبِ الصَّدَقَاتِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed the riba, the interest. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the sadaqat. Okay? Simple. I'm not going to make any comments. I'll just give the ayat. The second ayah, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ قَالُوا إِنَّمَا الْبَيْعُ مِثْلُ الرِّبَى. They said that the trade and business is same like interest. You make interest, contracts. But what Allah said, this is what they said. But what Allah said, وَأَحَلَّ اللَّهُ الْبَيْعَ وَحَرَّمَ الرِّبَى. Allah made the business, the trade, to buy and sell, halal. And Allah made the riba, the interest, haram. No comment. This, Allah said, وَحَرَّمَ الرِّبَى. A riba with all the types of riba. A small riba or big riba, same. Allah didn't say only the small, only the big, only this type. Or Allah حَرَّمَ الرِّبَى. That's what the ayah said. With all the names of the riba. Next. Allah said in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. O believers, this is call for us. اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Fear Allah. وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَى. And leave what's remaining from the riba. Distance yourself from the riba. إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. If you are really mu'mineen, if you are believers. فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا. If you don't want to do it, you have already involved in riba. And Allah is saying to us, be away from the riba. Distance yourself. Take it out. But if you don't want to do it, فَأْذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. فَأْذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ. There will be open war against you from Allah and His Messenger. War, that's fine. If you have more power, you want to join this war against Allah, here you go. Who's the more powerful? Junudullah. Junudullah. If we want to know Junudullah, the soldiers of Allah. Flu. We cannot even survive if we have a flu. We sit in our beds for 1 or 2 weeks. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can destroy our health, our wealth, our family, our work, our reputation, our name, many things. Junudullah, the soldiers of Allah, and the ways that Allah destroy us is easy. We know that. فَأَذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِ. خلاص, there is an open war if you don't want to do that. So the result of this war is clear. Next. الَّذِينَ يَأْكُلُونَ الرِّبَى. Those ones who eat the riba. لا يقومون when they stand in the resurrection in the and not only in the dunya but also when they are resurrected from their graves. لا يقومون إلا كما يقوم الذي يتخبطه الشيطان من المس. They will stand is like a person that he has jinn inside him, that there is shaitan missed him and touched him. So he is like a majnoon. He is mad. He is crazy. In his life and in his hashr and resurrection. Al-Bath. Next one. وَمَا أُوتِيتُمْ مِنْ رِبَى لِيَرْبُوا فِي أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ فَلَا يَرْبُوا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. The riba that you got, do you think so you can increase it and you have more wealth? It will not increase in the scale of Allah. You will have lots of problems from here and there and there and there and there, and the wealth will be destroyed. So it's not going to be any good after that. Next. وَأَخْذِهُمُ الرِّبَى وَقَدْ نُهُوا عَنْهُ. They talk the interest, talk Allah about the previous nations, and they were forbidden from doing it. وَأَكْلِهِمْ أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ. And they ate the wealth of people, the money of people. بالباطل, without justification, without حق, with false. وَأَعْتَدْنَا لِلْكَافِرِينَ مِنْهُمْ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا. Allah even called this, that this is the act of the kuffar. This is the act of the kuffar, and they deserve the great punishment. Many other ayat. But you know, I will end this ayat with one ayah, very amazing. Allah said, وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala putting example for us, for the Muslim nation. مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً, a village. قَرْيَة, town. Indeed, قَرْيَة means town. And this is referring to Mecca and people of Mecca in some of the tafsir. كانت آمنة مطمئنة. So it was secured, it has security, peace, people are happy. يأتيها رزقا رزقها رغدا من كل مكان. They have many resources and they have many doors for rizq, trade, business, farmers, many things. And the alhamdulillah, they have very good comfort and high standard living. فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ. And then they disbelieve in the ni'mah of Allah. They disbelieve in the ni'mah of Allah. فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ. فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the experience to test لباس الجوع, the poverty. Alhamdulillah, we have refugees everywhere. They don't even have food or water. Basic food they don't have. All over the world, Muslim Ummah. والخوف, the fear. The fear, no security in the Muslim Ummah, all over. بما كانوا يصنعون. And this is because what they did. Not this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to punish them, but because Allah gave them the ni'mah, Allah gave them the rizq, Allah gave them the resources, oil everywhere, gas everywhere. They are rich, they have lots of money, intelligence, manpower, but they denied this ni'mah and they didn't follow the commands of Allah. So Allah gave them the poverty. They backed the United Nations all over the world. And also the fear. They don't have security in their countries. They have no peace. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسن. وصلى الله عليه وسلم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله وبعد. Brothers in Islam, now very few hadith just selected her among list, long list of ahadith to support this ayat. And I will make the ahadith, the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, speak more powerful than any other words or statements. عن جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لعن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم cursed what? آكل الربا the one who ate riba the sued interest وموكله the one who pay the one who pay وكاتبه and the one who write, he wrote the contract, the writer, the officer, the accountant, وشاهديه and the two witnesses. وقال, what the Prophet ﷺ said, هم سواء, they are all the same. They are all equal. Equal in what? Equal in the sin, the ithm, the masiyah, and they are equal in the punishment. رواه مسلم. Second hadith. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. This hadith, the coming one, from البخاري. رحمة الله على البخاري. كل جسد, that's what the Prophet said. كل جسد نبت من السحت فالنار أولى به. Anybody that you grow and build from the سحت, from the حرام, so فالنار أولى به. It is for the fire, for the hellfire, for Jahannam. That's for the light of Jahannam, not the Jannah. Because cannot be built from haram and go to Jannah. Very clear. Another hadith similar, Tirmidhi, narrated it. لا يدخل الجنة جسد غذي بالحرام. There will not be a body, enter the Jannah and that body is fed from haram. Will not happen. It's forbidden for the Jahannam, for the Jannah, to receive anybody that ghuddiya, that fed with haram. It's gonna go to the hellfire. These are hadith, these are ayat. Remember. Now, Al-Hakim, bi isnad sahih, authentic hadith, also he said, إِذَا ظَهَرَ الزِّنَا وَالْرِبَا. If you see the zina and riba, the interest, and also the zina, the adultery, are spread all over. في قرية in a certain town, فقد أحلوا بأنفسهم عذاب الله. Then they are inviting the عذاب, the punishment of Allah against them. Next one, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, المصطفى, he said, الرiba 73 بابا, 73 doors of evil. أيسرها, the least, this is the smallest door of the riba, of the interest. مثل أزيف, a person, أن ينكح الرجل أمه, a person who make nikah to his mother. That's the least of the riba. If you want to imagine how bad it is, it is 73 doors of badness and evil. And the least of these 73 doors is as if the person is making nikah to his mother. Okay, I never mentioned the types of riba. I never mentioned the details and all this. I just mentioned the ayat and hadith. So to make it very clear from the Quran, from the hadith, no fatwa, no madahib, no masalik, no ulama statements. So because we believe in the Quran and the hadith, we all agree about the Quran and hadith. We may disagree about what the ulama says. But in the Quran and hadith, we all agree. Then we have to feel scared and frightened if the riba comes to us intentionally or maybe unintentionally. Sometimes you go, you see, unintentionally you got it, or you paid it, or by mistake, or a contract that you signed, you didn't look properly. It was very small font. So, we need to be frightened, scared, that's true, because it's a serious matter, And when we have any transaction in our life, we make sure that we are away from the riba. Not only us, also our family. All the bank accounts for our family, all the business of our family members, everything that under our care or responsibility. Also, our close friends, we make sure that they are away from this, because this will destroy them. And if they are destroyed, of course we are destroyed, because we love them. We love our relatives, our friends. We don't want our parents to be destroyed. We don't want our children to be destroyed, our wives or husbands to be destroyed, our relatives, our friends, our community. So we need to be sure that we are away from the riba, all types of riba. Brothers in Islam, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give all the Muslim ummah the peace and security and the understanding of the Islam, so we understand that this is forbidden. Allah said to us forbidden, we obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah. Of course, there are many wisdoms and reasons behind why it is forbidden. And there are many types of riba, there are many. So this khutbah is not for that. This khutbah is to say what the Quran and the hadith, authentic hadith, said about the riba. So we may, this will be like a call and waking up for us, because we know it, but when you hear it all together in one list, the ayat and the hadith, this will give us the full picture how dangerous, how serious it is. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أعنا على أنفسنا بفعل الطاعات وترك المنكرات. اللهم أحينا مسلمين وتوفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين غير خزايا ولا مفتونين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم سلمنا من الربا وشره. اللهم سلمنا من الربا وشره ومن الربا وغباره. اللهم سلم أهلنا أجمعين. اللهم سلم المسلمين أجمعين من الربا وشره. اللهم وعاقبة أمره وسوء خاتمته. اللهم سلمنا في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم استرنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض عليك يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نحبك حبا عظيما ونحب رسولك صلى الله عليه وسلم حبا جما. اللهم احشرنا تحت رايته واجمعنا به يوم القيامة. اللهم إنا نسألك الفردوس الأعلى لوالدينا ووالد والدينا ولمن له حق علينا من المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. إنك قريب مجيب الدعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد والحمد لله رب العالمين.